Good day, everyone! Today, I will introduce to you the autobiography, The Life and Literatures of Paz Marquez Benitez. It was the year 1894, the third day of March, when Paz Marquez Benitez came into the world through the way of birth. She was born in the city of Lucena in the province of Quezon, Philippines. On November 10, 1983, she passed away. Her professions are educator, writer, and editor with a focus on short stories. Benitez went to college at the University of the Philippines. In 1912, Benitez graduated with a Bachelor of Arts degree in Liberal Arts. Paz Benitez was one of the first Filipinos to be educated in the United States and was among the first generation of Filipinos trained in the American education system. So she is well educated in English language. Benitez continued her education at the age of 9 and attended high school at Tayabas High School and now it's Quezon National High School, where she graduated in 1910. Paz's parents both went into school and became teachers, which is instilled in her heart a deep regard and respect for the profession of a teacher. She began playing basketball at the age of 16 and eventually became the team captain. In high school, she was deemed a studious and excellent student, which would lead her into post-secondary education. She was committed to her passion, which is writing. When she first started teaching, her students proclaimed she was the mother of all. Paz Marquez married Francisco Benitez, the head of the University of the Philippines School of Education, 2 years after graduating from college. She was a professional educator, professor at her alma mater, where she teaches in the English department and short stories composition. She has a 35 years of experience in teaching, then she retired on 1951. Paz Benitez and her husband established the educational magazine when she retired as a teacher. She took it as an opportunity as a writer and editor. From 1916 through 1951, she earned a reputation as an outstanding teacher in the university. She took over as an editor of the Philippine Journal of Education at UP after her husband died in 1951. She was the editor-in-chief for more than 2 decades. Paz Marquez is most known in her story that made her literature very important, and her writings would be regarded as the first steps of Philippine literature moving into the mainstream. Benitez's first short tale, The Dead Star, is regarded as the first Filipino modern English language short fiction. Her work is regarded as the first contemporary Philippine short tale, making her a literary icon in the Philippines. She is a pioneering literary mentor in the Philippines, having served as a role model for a new generation of writers. Moreover, she started educational journals, schools, and contributed to the creation of creative writing courses in the Philippines with the help of her spouse. Marquez Benitez created short stories critical of American imperialism during her career as a writer. In 1925, she wrote her first major short tale, Dead Stars, in the Philippine Herald. Dead Stars became a well-received work of Philippine literature and a source of inspiration for several Filipino authors. These works of hers represent reminiscence from the past, the desire for something that does not exist, and cheating. I will give you a short summary of the plot of The Dead Stars. It talks about one man cheating with the affair of his life. He is a man who believes in true love and met a woman that he passionately loves. Then after their engagement, he met another woman who is more beautiful and attractive than her fiancé. But in the end, their affair didn't last. After the man longing for that lady he had an affair with, he met her later on, but then he realizes that he doesn't truly love her. Is it because of her beauty that fades? He asks himself. And now he understands that his feelings for her are just lost in imagination. back to the topic. That would not be her last work. She would go on to write short pieces like A Night in the Hills, which is her second story. It refers to a man, salesman, who was confused and was longing for a trip or a hike in the forest of which he dreamed of. When he has a chance to go on the forest that he always dreamed of, he pursues it. As time goes by, he realizes that forest is not his things, and the way he sees forest through his eyes is not he imagined, and it is not what he expected to what he sees in his dream. He realized that he should get back to reality. Her other story is titled Stepping Stone, which will be her third story. Albeit the two stories were not as highly acclaimed as Dead Stars, but it is not a reason for her not to be known. She founded the first women's magazine in the country, which is named Women's Home Journal in 1919. Furthermore, she created Filipino love stories from the efforts of her students in 1928. Reputedly, the first anthology of Philippine stories written in English by Filipinos. Marquez Pitines remained as a prominent influence on Philippine literature through not only her writing but her impact as an educator and editor. The yearly held Paz Marquez Pitines lecture by Ateneo praises her memory by zeroing on its commitment on Filipino lady scholar to Philippine literature in the English language. Furthermore, consistently there is an award or honor that addresses Paz Marquez's work and her impression of commitments in writing. Gawad Paz Marquez Pitines Awardee. Until this day, Paz Marquez Pitines has a very special place in the hearts of Philippine literature, for she steps up the milestone of this country literature and it inspires Filipino writers to continue our talents in writing. This is the end of our discussion. Thank you for watching and understanding the life of the author of the day. I hope this inspires you to choose the passion that grieves in your heart. Thank you! Bye!